Today we are going to learn our very favorite chapter and the first chapter, The Town Mouse and the Country Mouse. Very excited? Yes, as we have seen many mouse and cat stories since our childhood, like Tom and Jerry, that is your loving cartoon serial. So we have this story with us and let us enjoy this story. Before we begin, let us see the picture that has been shown in the starting of the chapter. What it says, look at these two pictures and answer the question that follow. First, look at the picture which is at the left side. What do you see? We see that there are houses with sloping roofs and the people who are there in the picture, which is left side, they are having, they are wearing very simple clothes and they seem to be working in farms. So it is the picture of a village. Now look at the picture at your right side. Here we have big buildings, high skyscrapers, and we have a lot of traffic on the road, moving a lot of vehicles on it. Some of the public vehicles and some are the transport vehicles like lorries carrying luggages on it. So now we have these two pictures side by side. So what is being shown on the right side? Yes, this is the picture of a town or a city. So we have a few questions after this. Shall we try to answer them? Let us see. Write the differences you notice between the things you see in the two pictures. Can you identify the differences? Yes, we can easily identify. Let us see. We can see that there are small houses and very few in the village, but there are very big houses and they are more in number in the town. So we can say that the population in village is very less and the population of the cities is very high. What else we can see? There are the house which are there in the village, they look quite old style. They are not that big. But on the right side we have very huge building, which shows that how our engineering level has reached. So we can say that in villages we don't have much facilities to live, but in cities we have big houses with air conditioned rooms, proper electricity, proper home furnishings and everything to entertain us. So this is the difference between town and the country. Country is nothing but the village. What are the other things you can see? You can see that the lifestyle of the village people is very simple, but the lifestyle of the city people is quite modern. Next question says, where do you think life is peaceful and why? So it's obvious that the life in the village is quite peaceful because we don't have much rush of traffic on the roads. We don't have factories and offices. We don't have vehicles that are continuously rushing over the road. So it shows that in villages the life is more peaceful, and in the cities and towns we have more busy and rushful life. Next question is, do animals feel the same like you? Definitely, even the animals also have the sense. That is why animals, you can often see different kinds of animals in the village area, but you won't be able to see them in the town areas. So this is the situation and this is the difference between the countryside and the town side. Now you have to tell me, which type of locality do you want to live? Do Do you love village? Do you love peaceful and natural environment of the village? Or you love the modern lifestyle of the city? Try to discuss this. So without wasting time, let us start the most awaited story, the town mouse and the country mouse. Let us start the reading part. The title is The Town Mouse and the Country Mouse. The town mouse and the country mouse were cousins. They often wrote to each other. One day, the country mouse got his letter from his cousin. So, who were the two mouses? How they were related? They were cousins. And they used to communicate between each other through letters. So now, who has written the letter? The country mouse has received the letter from his cousin who lives in the town. So what the town mouse is writing to the country mouse? Let us read that very interesting letter which is given below. The location of the country mouse is in the village, and the location of the town mouse is the kitchen cupboard. Mouse town. And what is the date of the writing letter? 11th March 2012. What he says? Dear cousin, I have been ill with cough and my doctor feels I need a holiday. He has advised me to spend a week in the countryside. May I stay with you? Please give me an early reply. With warm regards, yours affectionately, Town Mouse. To whom he is writing? Country Mouse. What is the address of Country Mouse? The mouse hole, mouse country. So this was the situation. The town mouse was sick. He was suffering from disease. So what his doctor has advised? The doctor has advised that you should spend few days in a village. So the town mouse remembered that my cousin lives in village, that is countryside. So he is writing this letter to ask to the country mouse that I want to stay with you for some time. Can I come to your house? The town mouse is asking to the country mouse. So now what happens? The word affectionately means lovingly. What does it mean? Lovingly. So what happens next? Receiving the invitation from the country mouse, the town mouse packed his bags and caught the next train to the countryside. The day was bright and sunny. Soon the town mouse began to feel hot in the train. So what was happening? The country mouse agreed to call his town cousin and he was very happy to have him in the village. So, after hearing this from the country mouse, what he did? Who? The town mouse. What did he do? He packed his bag. What is the meaning of packing a bag? Means keeping necessary things into a bag for travel purpose. So, he has done all the packing and he has caught the next train. Now, the town mouse was habituated of the cozy environment in the city. But now he has started his journey towards the village, and slowly, slowly he has started to feel the heat of the summer season. Now he was very sweating because it was a sunny day. Now, I wish there was an air conditioning coach, he said to himself. I feel very uncomfortable here. Who is saying these words? Who is imagining this? The town mouse. He is saying these words to himself that I wish it would have been an air conditioned coach. Why didn't he come into an air conditioned coach? Because the train in which he came, it did not have an air conditioned coach. That is why he was telling that I was very uncomfortable. Next he says, however, there was nothing he could do about it. So he grumbled to himself while the train chugged slowly into the country. So he did not have any option. So what he did, he grumbled to himself while the train chugged slowly into the country. So what is the meaning of grumbled? He was speaking to himself while the train chugged. What is the meaning of chugged? Chugged is nothing but the sound made by the train engine while the train moves. So he was talking to himself. The country mouse was waiting at the station. Now country mouse was very excited for the arrival of his cousin, since it was a really long time that they have seen each other. He was very happy. So, "Oh cousin," the town mouse said as soon as he got off the train. So the train stopped at the station and the town mouse, along with his luggage, gets off the train, and as soon as he sees his cousin, he tells in excitement that, "Oh cousin." What happens next? The train was dreadful. His face was full of irritation. He was saying that the train was a mess. It was very uncomfortable. Dreadful means very uncomfortable. What he says, "I feel terribly hot and thirsty. After this long journey, this sunny day felt me a lot of painful, and now I'm feeling so much thirsty. Give me something to drink." "So, I hope you have something ice cold for me to drink at home." So, what he was expecting from the country mouse? He was expecting something icy cool, like he used to have in the town side, in the kitchens of the houses in the town side. They used to have fridge and all. So, he was habituated to eat all the cold things, cold and icy things. So, he was expecting the same thing from the country mouse. But was it true? What happens with the town mouse? Let us see in the story. I hope you are catching it quite well. "So, well, I have some water," said the country mouse. The poor country mouse had only just the plain water, since the country did not have that much of facilities as the town mouse had. So he offered what he had with him. So what was it? It was nothing but plain water. "But I can look around for some coconut water if you like." So the country mouse promised that as the town mouse was his guest, so he will make an attempt and he will try to bring some coconut water for him. So like that, the country mouse tried to welcome his cousin from the city. Let us say, "Coconut water?" asked the town mouse in horror. "Don't you have any orange juice or lemonade?" Now he's demanding quite fancy. What he is asking for? "Why are you offering me coconut water? Don't you have some orange juice or lemonade? Can we expect to have a lemonade or orange juice frequently in a village? It's quite hard to find, or sometimes we can't even get it." But the town mouse was expecting the same what he had in the town side. So let us see. "I'm afraid not." The country mouse was very upset that he could not provide the things that town mouse was asking to him. So he says that, "I'm afraid not," replied his cousin. "But I found a very nice piece of root today and a tender bit of sugarcane. I'm sure you will enjoy that." So whatever fancy, whatever the tasty food country mouse had with him, he was ready to provide him. So what was the food the country mouse was having? He was having a root and a piece of sugarcane. So again town mouse says that, "Root, sugarcane?" The town mouse exclaimed, "But I don't eat raw foods like that. again he is speaking like a town man and says that, do you eat raw food? I don't like to eat raw foods. I can't eat roots and sugarcane like that. I want some cooked food, he asks. So what happens later? The country mouse said, this is what we eat in the country. So I'm afraid you too have to eat this. Try it, it's not bad. So the country mouse was not sure that how to bring all those things. So he says that, okay brother, we don't have much more things. That's what we eat in the countryside, and you should also try this, it's not bad. So this happens, and what happens next, we will read it out. The town mouse did not enjoy his dinner at all. He nibbled at the root and sugar cane and then said he wanted to sleep. The country mouse showed a corner in the mouse hole and said, there you are, you can sleep there. Again, there was a disaster for the town mouse. He was habituated to live in a cozy environment. But again and again, the town mouse was facing a terrible environment as he did not enjoy his dinner also. So he wanted to sleep. So what he said, he just nibbled the roots and sugar cane. Nibbled means putting the teeth on that and just leaving it as it is. So what he said, he asked his cousin living in the village that, I want to sleep now, where shall I go? So the country mouse shows one corner in the mouse hole and he says to him that, now you can go there and you can sleep. So what happens next? On the ground, asked the town mouse, do I have to sleep on the ground? Yes, this is how we sleep in the country, his cousin answered. So these all things were new for the town mouse. The town mouse actually was habituated of a luxurious life. He did not expect himself to sleep on the ground. That's why he asks this strange question to the country mouse. But the country mouse couldn't do anything because that's how they lived in the countryside. So that's why he says that, that's how we sleep in the countryside. As the town mouse lay down on the hard, cold ground, he suddenly thought of something. Cousin, he called out. So what happened? He suddenly shouts as he tries to lie down on the hard, cold surface. When you sleep on the bare ground, how does it feel during the night? It feels too cold. So the same feeling he was getting, and suddenly he shouted, cousin, he called. Yes, what is it? The country mouse asked. Immediately he replies, and what he says, why is it so quiet here? Where are all the cars and lorries? Where are the radios and the televisions? Where are all the lights? He says, he was habituated of listening to all the vibrations and sounds of traffic and radios and televisions during the night time, as the city never stops, whether it is a day or night. So he was missing all those things. The peace was not his kind of thing. So he was asking his brother that, where is all the noise gone? Why it is so peaceful? What happens then? This is how it is in the country. Again, the country mouse replies that we cannot expect the same environment as we had in the town, in the countryside. So brother, you have to live like this only. The cousin replied, it's always quiet in the country. Sometimes it's quieter than today. So he says to him that, today is a little bit noisy. But even some days, even the environment will be quieter than this also. Then what will you do? So, my brother, you should try to sleep. Then what happens? Let us see. My grandfather says that our village is the quietest among all villages in our district. So what his grandpa says? He says that it is the quietest village in all the district. Oh, is it? The country is a strange place, said the town mouse. But he said to himself, I don't think I like this place. Then what happens? He says that the country or the village appears to be a strange place to the town mouse, because the environment over there was not suitable for the town mouse. He was missing the sounds of traffic. He was missing the lights of traffic. So it was all a strange and new experience for him, and he didn't like it. So that is why he says that next morning the town mouse found that there was no breakfast ready. His cousin told him that they had to go to the nearby farm in search of food. In town side, the town mouse used to get prepared food early in the morning. But in the countryside, he did not have such things. They need to work hard in order to get their breakfast. They need to visit a nearby field and they need to search for their breakfast. So that was too strange for him. So what he says, we are sure to find something there, he said, a nice piece of root or a tender bit of sugarcane. So they were about to visit a field nearby their mouse hole, and the country mouse says that surely we will find something nice to eat. Maybe it is some root or a tender bit of sugarcane. But the town mouse had enough. Thank you, cousin, he said, but I think I'll catch the next train home. I have suddenly remembered that I have forgotten something. Now, the town mouse doesn't want to stay there anymore. He wanted to leave that place immediately. So he says to the country mouse that, that's quite enough, my dear cousin. Thank you so much for everything. I think that I should catch the next train to the city, to the town, and because I forgot something over there. He's trying to give a reason to him, trying to explain that why he wants to leave so early. So what happens next is, I will tell you. A few days later, the country mouse wrote to his cousin and the town mouse. Here is the letter. So what happens? The town mouse returns to the city, to his hometown. And now the country mouse writes a letter to the town mouse. Now here is another letter, and we are very excited to read it. Let us see what is the letter. So the country mouse is writing the letter from the mouse hole where he lived, and the date is 22nd March 2012. He writes, my dear cousin, I hope you are well. I am worried about you. I would like to visit you and make sure you are all right. With love, your cousin, Country Mouse. And he has written this letter to the town mouse who lives in kitchen cupboard. So why the country mouse has written this letter to his cousin? Because he was worried about him. He just lived for one day in the country and he left. But his doctor has advised him to spend some days in the countryside. So in order to find whether the town mouse is okay or not, the country mouse is asking that, I would like to visit you and I will like to find whether you are doing well or not. So he has written the letter that I will be visiting you in the town. So this was the letter written by the country mouse to the town mouse. The town mouse received the letter and read it. So, as the country mouse has written the letter to the town mouse, he received it and read it. Since he was in hurry, he sent a telegram to the country mouse. Here is his telegram. What was the telegram over there? Overjoyed, come soon, town mouse. Now, likewise, I told you that the life in city, the towns, is very busy and very rushful. So, instead of writing and posting a letter, what did the town mouse do? He has written a telegram to the country mouse. So, a telegram is a means of sending a message very quickly in those days. Now, we have telephones, text messages, and emails that we can easily send to the other people. But in earlier days, they had telegram to convey their messages in very short term. So, instead of writing the whole letter, he has written, overjoyed, come soon, town mouse. He says that, I am really happy that you are coming over here. Overjoyed means, and come soon means, come as early as possible, yours, town mouse. The meaning of the telegram is this. Now, what happens? A few days later, the country mouse arrived in the town. He was surprised by the noise and the lights. Now, as earlier, it was a new experience for the town mouse in the country. The same thing was with the country mouse in the town. He didn't have such a bright kind of life in the village. He was quite surprised by seeing the noise and lights. He was habituated of living in a peaceful, quiet place. Now, why are there lights even in the middle of the night? He asks. To whom? He asks this question to the town mouse. What did he ask? He asks that, why are there lights even in the middle of the night? Since we know that the towns and the cities run for the whole 24 hours, whether it is day or night. That is why he found the light to be turned on within the middle of the night itself. So, what happens next is, this is town. The cousin replied, here there are lights even in the middle of the day. So, the same answer which we would have been expecting from a town person was being given to the country mouse. He told him that, this is city, this is town, my brother, and we will be seeing lights even in middle of the day. This is a busy place and we require light and electricity at every point of our life. So, this is what we have learned in our today's class. The remaining part of this lesson, this story, we will be hearing in our next class. Till then, I hope.